He stuck it to my Spurs. And now he stuck it to Shannon Sharpe's Lakers. Congratulations, LeBron.
Talk to us.
Prices just went up.
Don't talk to us. Don't talk to us.
Like, my boys, come with me to LA. Where we going, cuz?
We coming home.
We coming home, cuz.
Clipper Darryl. This is not a dream. This shit came true. Y'all got Kawhi Leonard. Good shit. Congratulations to Kawhi for coming back to LA. New contract. A new situation. I wish him luck. Still the Lakers, though. So, Clipper Dale, you got your little dream come true. You got Paul George, too. We'll be hollering at y'all all season. Lakers.
Miss out on Kawhi.
I did warn you, though. So let's give Rob Pelinka benefit of the doubt.
Right. No, that's what I'm leading
to. Maybe Magic Johnson was the problem.
Right. And since then, they miss out on Kawhi. They get Danny Green, who would have been one of my premier targets to begin it. I'm not as high on Boogie as some people, but for the price, there's no doubt on the upside. You find a way to bring in Avery Bradley. You bring in guys that Jared Dudley, who won't play much, but is a good fit. Like, your Troy Daniels is a shooter. Don't you think they've done a good job since Magic walked away as far as player acquisition
stuff? No question that, after Kawhi went to the Clippers, no question they did a great job. You have to give him an A. But that in and of itself is not going to dismiss a lot of the other stuff that
no
still
doubt
went on. And like you said, they made good moves, but they still, like, they don't have a GM. You know, Rob Pelinka's the GM. They don't have a president.
Right.
You know, and Kurt Rambis is like a special advisor, but he's got as much power as anybody when it comes to basketball operations. So the way they hired Frank Vogel,
oh,
you know,
it's
the
a mess.
Way they only
it's
gave Ty Lue a 3-year offer. So those types of things, I will be the first to say they did a great job after Kawhi. However, I still give the Clippers a big advantage.
Well, if you take the two teams and take out the superstars, take out the four of them, because some could argue they're both even. There's so much more stability with regards to the Clippers. The head coach, the organization, the role players, the bench, the way they play basketball, the personalities, the fact that they all know what role they're going to play. It just seems like top to bottom, the Clippers seem like they have so much more stability than the
Lakers. Well, let's focus, since we've talked about everything except for the players, let's focus on the players part of it. Remove those top four guys, like you said, LeBron and AD, Paul George and Kawhi. Just take them out. I think the better duos with the Lakers. Some people think it's with the Clippers. Who cares? Call it a wash. The rest of the roster, if we go to Kuzma, to Danny Green, Boogie Cousins, Avery Bradley, your next four, versus it'd be Lou Williams, Patrick Beverley, Trez Harrell, and then I guess Landry Shamet. I don't know who their fourth guy would be. To me, those are pretty comparable. Well, it's not the Clippers know their roles more, but to me, you can't say they are clearly the more talented supporting cast.
In a vacuum, I would say the Lakers had. I mean, obviously they have more star power, Rondo and DeMarcus. Yeah, on paper, I would give their supporting cast the advantage.
Yes.
But with the coaching, with the attitudes,
you know your
knowing
role.
Your role, that is better. Yeah. That is in favor of the Clippers. I don't know what the drama will be with the Lakers. Hopefully there is none.
Oh, there will be some.
But, yeah, I mean, and a lot of that's got to be.
Miss out on Kawhi.
I did warn you, though. So let's give Rob Pelinka benefit of the doubt.
Right. No, that's what I'm
Maybe
leading
Maybe Magic
to.
Johnson was the problem.
Right. And since then, they miss out on Kawhi. They get Danny Green, who would have been one of my premier targets to begin it. I'm not as high on Boogie as some people, but for the price, there's no doubt on the upside. You find a way to bring in Avery Bradley. You bring in guys that Jared Dudley, who won't play much but is a good fit. Like, your Troy Daniels is a shooter. Don't you think they've done a good job since Magic walked away as far as player acquisition stuff?
No question that after Kawhi went to the Clippers, no question they did a great job. You have to give him an A. But that in and of itself is not going to dismiss a lot of the other stuff that
no
still
doubt
went on. And like you said, they made good moves, but they still, like, they didn't hire, they don't have a GM. You know, well, Rob Pelinka's the GM. They don't have a president.
Right.
You know, and Kurt Rambis is like a special advisor, but he's got as much power as anybody when it comes to basketball operations. So the way they hired Frank Vogel,
the way they only gave Ty Lue a three-year offer.
So those types of things, I will be the first to say they did a great job after Kawhi. However, I still give the Clippers a big advantage.
Well, if you take the two teams and take out the superstars, take out the four of them, because some could argue they're both even. There's so much more stability with regards to the Clippers. The head coach, the organization, the role players, the bench, the way they play basketball, the personalities, the fact that they all know what role they're going to play. It just seems like top to bottom, the Clippers seem like they have so much more stability than the Lakers.
Well, let's focus, since we've talked about everything except for the players, let's focus on the players part of it. Remove those top four guys, like you said, LeBron and AD, Paul George and Kawhi. Just take them out. I think the better duos with the Lakers. Some people think it's with the Clippers. Who cares? Call it a wash. The rest of the roster, if we go to Kuzma, to Danny Green, Boogie Cousins, Avery Bradley, your next four versus it'd be Lou Williams, Patrick Beverley, Trez Harrell, and then I guess Landry Shamet. I don't know who their fourth guy would be. To me, those are pretty comparable. Well, it's not the Clippers know their roles more, but to me, you can't say they are clearly the more talented supporting cast.
In a vacuum, I would say the Lakers had. I mean, obviously they have more star power with Rondo and DeMarcus. Yeah, on paper, I would give their supporting cast the advantage.
Yes.
But with the coaching, with the attitudes,
you know your role, that is better.
Yeah. That is in favor of the Clippers. There's going to. I don't know what the drama will be with the Lakers. Hopefully there is none.
Oh, there will be some.
But, yeah, I mean, and a lot of that's got to be laid at the feet of LeBron. I don't know what mm-hmm. what was the last season he didn't have some drama. So there may
Saint
be
Vincent,
drama.
St. Mary.
All right. So there's not going to be drama.
It was drama there because he got the Hummer in. Remember?
Oh, yeah.
You're right.
Junior year, St. Vincent. Yeah. St.
There's other people LeBron fans besides you, bro. I've been watching.
Probably junior high. Yeah. So that's LeBron. There's not going to be drama with the Clippers. I don't imagine. I mean, I don't see it with these guys, and that is an advantage in their favor.
Well, two advantages. Coming off the bench, you know you got a proven instant offense in Lou Williams.
All right? Question.
Now, Kuz, I'm high on Kuz. But if you give me a guy in a game seven who I need to be the third scorer, Lou Williams has proven that. Without a shadow of a doubt, he's one of the best that's ever played in this business. We know the continuity, the buy-in. Huge advantage on the defense. They got three all-NBA players starting. Patrick Beverley is a beast, and he fits perfect with Kawhi and Paul George, and they have better matchups against LeBron. They got two of the better defenders and wing defenders in Kawhi and Paul George going against LeBron. To me right now, the Clippers have the advantages with all this stuff.
I'm glad you mentioned Lou, because I don't think the two guys that benefit the most from this summer individually might be Lou Williams and Kyle Kuzma. For those two guys, they will never be double teamed for the next 2 years. Lou Williams, if you remember in that series against Golden State, what happened in game six was they said, man, anyone but miss out on Kawhi.
I did warn you, though. So let's give Rob Pelinka benefit of the doubt.
Right. No, that's what I'm leading
to. Maybe Magic Johnson was the problem.
Right. And since then, they miss out on Kawhi. They get Danny Green, who would have been one of my premier targets to begin it. I'm not as high on Boogie as some people, but for the price, there's no doubt on the upside. You find a way to bring in Avery Bradley. You bring in guys that Jared Dudley, who won't play much, but is a good fit. Like your Troy Daniels is a shooter. Don't you think they've done a good job since Magic walked away as far as player acquisition
no
stuff?
No question that after Kawhi went to the Clippers, no question they did a great job. You have to give them an A. But that in and of itself is not going to dismiss a lot of the other stuff that went on. And like you said, they made good moves, but they still, like, they don't have a GM. You know, Rob Pelinka's the GM. They don't have a president.
Right.
You know, and Kurt Rambis is like a special advisor, but he's got as much power as anybody when it comes to basketball operations. So the way they hired Frank Vogel,
the way they only gave
Ty Lue a three-year offer. So those types of things, I will be the first to say they did a great job after Kawhi. However, I still give the Clippers a big advantage.
Well, if you take the two teams and take out the superstars, take out the four of them, because some could argue they're both even. There's so much more stability with regards to the Clippers. The head coach, the organization, the role players, the bench, the way they play basketball, the personalities, the fact that they all know what role they're going to play. It just seems like top to bottom, the Clippers seem like they have so much more stability than the
Lakers. Let's focus, since we've talked about everything except for the players, let's focus on the players part of it. Remove those top four guys, like you said, LeBron and AD, Paul George and Kawhi. Just take them out. I think the better duos with the Lakers. Some people think it's with the Clippers. Who cares? Call it a wash. The rest of the roster, if we go to Kuzma, to Danny Green, Boogie Cousins, Avery Bradley, your next four versus it'd be Lou Williams, Patrick Beverly, Trez Harrell, and then I guess Landry Shamet. I don't know who their fourth guy would be. To me, those are pretty comparable. Well, it's not the Clippers know their roles more, but to me, you can't say they are clearly the more talented supporting cast.
In a vacuum, I would say the Lakers had. I mean, obviously they have more star power with Rondo and DeMarcus. Yeah, on paper, I would give their supporting cast the advantage.
Yes.
But with the coaching, with the attitudes, that is in favor of the Clippers. I don't know what the drama will be with the Lakers. Hopefully there is none.
Oh, there will be some.
But, yeah, I mean, and a lot of that's got to be laid at the feet of LeBron. I don't know what was the last season he didn't have some drama. So there may be
Vincent,
drama.
St. Mary.
All right. So there's not going to be
drama. It was drama then because he got the Hummer then. Remember?
Oh, yeah. You're right. Junior year, St. Vincent.
Yeah. Yeah. There's other people LeBron fans besides you, bro. I've been watching.
Right. Yeah. Probably junior high. Yeah. So that's LeBron.